बहुत ज्यादा इफेक्ट पड़ता है स्पेशली ड्यूरिंग द कोस्टल एरियाज. ओके एंड ड्यू टू विच द प्लेसेज विच आर अवे फ्रॉम द विच आर अवे फ्रॉम दैट कोस्टल एरियाज यानी द प्लेसेज जो कोस्टल एरिया से दूर होते हैं वहां पे एक्सट्रीम टेम्परेचर पाया जाता है. दैट इज एज आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू एक्सट्रीम टेम्परेचर मीन्स टू वेरी टू हॉट एंड टू कोल्ड. इज इट क्लियर? ओके नाउ रीड आइसोलेशन. यस वर्षा यू कैन रीड आइसोलेशन.
Isolation. The incoming solar energy received by the earth is called isolation, but it is not the same everywhere. It is maximum at the equator and minimum towards the poles. In any given day, the strongest isolation is received at noon.
Okay, just a second. 1 minute. Okay, now this isolation is same which we have done that the in the latitude explanation that sun rays fall vertically at the equator and slanting at the poles. So it is same. That is this incoming solar energy, that is the incoming solar energy which is received by the earth is known as isolation. And again it is not same everywhere because we know that sun rays fall vertically over the equator. So this isolation is also maximum at the equator because there is too much heat received at the equator, and it is minimum at the pole because the sun rays fall vertically at the pole and there is not much heat over there. So, and also we know that at noon, that is 12 o'clock in the afternoon, at the noon time the sun gives the maximum of its heat. So this isolation is also strongest. यानी सबसे ज्यादा आइसोलेशन होता है, सबसे ज्यादा हीट एनर्जी रिसीव होती है सन से एट द टाइम ऑफ नून. दैट इज जब नून दिन में 12 बजे होते हैं उस समय सबसे ज्यादा गर्मी होती है. दैट इज मैक्सिमम सन एनर्जी इज रिसीव्ड बाय द अर्थ. ओके नाउ इट इज सेइंग दैट व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स विच अफेक्ट द आइसोलेशन. नाउ यू कैन रीड वर्षा.
ओके मैम. Factors that affect isolation without the effect of atmosphere. First, angle of the sun. Second, distance between the sun and the earth. Third, duration of daylight. The longer the duration of daylight, the more the isolation received.
Okay, now it is saying what are the factors which affect isolation. Same, angle of the sun. Okay, when the angle of the sun is at, it is falling vertically, again the heat more will be received. And it will be too hot. Angle of the sun, distance between the earth and the sun. The larger the distance between the earth and the sun, the less heat will be received and it will be less hot as compared to the shorter distance when there is a shorter distance between earth and the sun. And duration of daylight, yani din ki roshni, yani if that is during the summers, as we know, days are longer during the summers and shorter during the winters. So longer the duration of daylight, yani jitna zyada der tak din rahega, the more isolation will be received. That is more and more of the sun energy will be received by the earth. Okay, and because this happens during the summer season, as we know that during the summer the sun is the days are longer. So what happens, more of the for a longer duration we receive the sunlight and it becomes more hot due to the more of the sun energy received by the earth. Is it clear? Next you can read cloud cover.
Ma'am, ye jo bahar blue color ka bana hua hai earth ke bahar, ye atmosphere hai jo earth cover kar rakha hai.
In this figure?
Yes ma'am.
It is water. एटमॉस्फेयर बट द डार्कर पार्ट इन साइड द सर्कल दैट इज वॉटर बिकॉज वी नो दैट थ्री फोर्थ ऑफ द लैंड सर्फेस इज कवर्ड विद वॉटर ना दैट इज वॉटर. ओके okay Sujan.
Yes ma'am.
Okay next read Varsha. Give Vaishali chance to read.
cloud cover influence the temperature of a place as it affects the incoming and outgoing solar radiation of the atmosphere. It acts like an umbrella, checks the solar radiation in the day and prevents the loss of heat from the lower layers of air at night. Winds, ocean, currents, slope of the land, soil, and vegetation cover are other factors which influence the temperature of a place.
Okay, now next factor which affect the temperature of a given area is the cloud cover. Now, cloud cover, it affects the temperature of a place because it affects the incoming and outgoing of the sun radiation of the atmosphere. That is, when it is cloudy over in the sky, what happens? The sun heat which is received by the Earth's surface is also, if it is prior to the cloud cover, it is received and it acts as a barrier. When the clouds are there, it acts as a barrier in the coming and the going, coming and going of the sun's energy, due to which it's just like an umbrella. For example, if you are holding an umbrella in your hand and it is raining, what happens? You cannot get wet because that umbrella is blocking the path of the water and preventing you from getting wet. Similarly, this cloud cover, clouds also act as an umbrella and they check the solar radiation in the day and prevent the loss, which due to which they prevent the loss of the heat from the Earth's surface. That is, jab clouds ho jayenge, to heat jo hai, they will act as a barrier and the heat which is received by the Earth's surface during the daytime will not be able to move back into the space. Okay. And these were the five important factors: latitude, altitude, distance from the sea, isolation, and cloud cover. So apart from these, the other factors are also there. And they are wind, ocean current, slope of the land, soil and vegetation. All these are the other important factors which affect the temperature of a, which affect the temperature of a place. Is it clear?
Yes,
ma'am. Okay. Vanshika, am I audible to you? Yes, Vanshika.
Ma'am, you are audible.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, read. Yes, read. Who has started this music? Seventh class, who has started this music? Can you hear Palak? Palak, can you hear?
No, ma'am. I'm listening.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Ma'am, kis nahi baj raha koi bhi music?
Ma'am.
Okay, now next is measurement of temperature. You can read, Palak. Next is measurement of temperature. When we have talked about temperature, factors affecting the temperature, the next question is, how do we measure this temperature? Okay, read it.
Measure of temperature. The instrument used to measure temperature is called thermometer. The temperature of the air is measured in degrees. The two most common thermometer scales in use are second line highlighted virtual.
Yes, read, Palak.
Have you heard with Krishna? Thermometer scales in use are?
Use are Fahrenheit and Celsius or centigrade.
The maximum and minimum thermometers are used to measure the highest and the lowest temperature of the day. Apart from using these two thermometers, a single instrument can be used. The instrument is known as 6 maximum and minimum thermometer.
Okay, now it is saying that we can measure the temperature using the thermometer, and temperature of air is always measured in degrees. We all know that 35 degrees Celsius, 40 degrees Celsius, and the common thermometer scale, that is unit which is used, is Fahrenheit and Celsius. We all know that. We always write degree C or degree F. So these are the two scales which are used to measure the most common thermometer scales, and also maximum thermometer and minimum thermometer are the two thermometers which are used to measure the highest and the lowest temperature of the day. Apart from these two thermometers, a single instrument is also used. That is, using one single instrument, we can also measure the temperature of a place. And that single instrument is known as 6's maximum and minimum thermometer. Okay. Who will read next? Is Urvashi also there in the class? Okay. Urvashi, do you want to read? Urvashi. Okay, Vanchika, you can read.
Okay, ma'am.
Vanchika.
Heat zones. Aristotle, the ancient Greek philosopher, classified world climate into 3 major zones based on the main latitudes, or the distance of a zone from the equator, and the amount of heat received by each zone. The major heat zones are the torrid, temperate and frigid zones. Heat zone.
Okay. Now, just a second, Vanchika. Let me cover this first. Now, Aristotle, he was an ancient Greek philosopher, and he classified the world climate, as you can see in the figure next to it, whole world is shown. So, he classified this world climate into 3 major zones. First was torrid zone, temperate zone and frigid zone. Now, and these zones were classified on the basis of amount of heat received by each zone. Yani in mein se tino zone mein kitni zyada heat received hoti hai, depending upon that, he classified these world climate into 3 zones. First was torrid zone, temperate zone and frigid zone. Before explaining it, I would like you to go through this diagram first. Can you see in the diagram, everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Look into the diagram which is given. As you can see, the middle part of the earth, round earth, which is shown, it is torrid zone, and there is also an equator mark. And above it, that is in the northern hemisphere, first you can find the Tropic of Cancer, okay? And it is 23.5 degree north, and above it there is a north, Arctic Circle, which is 66.5 degree north. Okay, and when we come to the southern hemisphere, that is lower part, that is Tropic of Capricorn, it is 23.5 degrees south. Okay, and Antarctic Circle, which you can see, which marks the change between, or the change in the zone, that is temperate zone and frigid zone, that is Antarctic Circle, it is 66.5 degree south. Is it clear? Now, why I wanted to show you this, it is because only if you will know about this, only then you will be able to understand well this second column, location of the region. Okay? If you want to understand what is written here easily, you should know about this diagram first. So, if anybody, you can see that the first is torrid zone, then Tropic of Cancer starts, and it marks the beginning of the next zone, which is temperate zone. And then an Arctic Circle comes, which marks the beginning of the another zone, which is known as frigid zone. And these zones in the northern hemisphere are known as North Temperate Zone and North Frigid Zone. And these zones, in the these zones in the southern hemisphere are known as north temperate, south temperate zone and south frigid zone. Is it clear? So now you can read, Vanshika. First is torrid zone.
Okay, ma'am. Torrid zone. Location, the northern hemisphere between the equator and the Tropic of Cancer is 23.5 degrees north. The southern hemisphere between the equator and the Tropic of Capricorn is 23.5 degrees south.
Okay, features, now you can see, just a second. Now you can see its location, that is torrid zone. This entire torrid zone is also divided into two, north torrid zone and south torrid zone. As you can see, it starts from equator to the Tropic of Cancer, which is in the north. And in the north Tropic of Cancer, its degree is 23.5 degrees north. And when we come to the southern hemisphere, it is from the equator to the Tropic of Capricorn, which is at 23.5 degrees south. So this entire region, which is shown in brown orangish color, it is the torrid zone. Okay. And its features are, because it is because this region is covering the equatorial part. Okay. And we know that equator receives the vertical sun rays. There is maximum insolation near the equatorial region. So this region receives maximum insolation. Is it clear? That is, zyada se zyada garmi yahi receive hoti hai, and sun rays are almost vertical throughout the year. We know that near the equator, the sun rays falls vertically over there. And it is the hottest part of the Is it clear to everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now read Vanshika, you can read.
Temperate zone. Location, the northern hemisphere between the Tropic of Cancer is 23.5 degrees north, and the Arctic Circle is 66.5 degrees north. The southern hemisphere between the Tropic of Capricorn is 23.5 degrees south, and the Antarctic Circle is 66.5 degrees south. Its features, receives moderate insolation, region enjoys moderate temperature, neither too cold nor too hot.
Okay, now temperate zone, as we know that temperate zone in the northern part, it is known as north temperate zone, and it lies between Tropic of Cancer to Arctic Circle, and in the southern hemisphere, it lies between Tropic of Capricorn to the Antarctic Circle, and this receive moderate insulation, that is moderate means neither too hot nor too cold. Okay, and the region enjoy moderate temperature, that is, if it receive isolation and moderate level, then also the temperature is also moderate, that is neither too hot and nor too cold. Is it clear? Next is frigid zone. Read.
Frigid zone. Location, the northern hemisphere between the Arctic Circle is 66.5 degrees north and the North Pole. The southern hemisphere between the Antarctic Circle is 66.5 degrees south and the South Pole. Features, receives minimum insolation, sun rays are slanting throughout the year, coldest part of the earth.
Okay, it is all same as what we have done in the last topic. Again, from northern, from Arctic Circle to North Pole, it is North Frigid Zone. And from Antarctic Circle to the South Pole is the South Frigid Zone. And its features are minimum isolation, because sun rays fall slanting throughout the year. And because the sun rays are slanting, it do not receive much heat of the sun rays or receive less of the sun energy. So it is the coldest part of the earth. Is it clear to everybody? Ishika, read next. Air pressure. Ishika, you can read it. Who else want to read?
can I read?
Who?
Ma'am Urvashi.
Yeah, Urvashi, I called your name. You were not responding. You can read, Urvashi. Air pressure.
Yes. Air pressure. The weight of air extends a force on all non-living and living things within the atmosphere and on the Earth's surface. We call it air pressure or atmospheric pressure. It is measured in millibars by an instrument called a barometer. An Android barometer is the most convenient instrument used to measure atmospheric pressure. It works without mercury. Normal atmospheric pressure at sea level is 760 mm or 30 inches of mercury. When expressed in millibars, it is 1013 millibars. If the mercury rises above the point, we say that the air pressure is high, but when it falls below this point, the pressure is said to be low.
Okay, now it is saying that the air pressure, what is the weight of the air? That is, we know that air has weight, and we have already done this through the experiments also, that we fill the air in a balloon and then we weigh that balloon filled with air and we find that it has a weight as compared to the balloon in which there is no air and it's just a small piece of rubber. Okay, so we know that air has weight. And it always exerts a force on non-living and living things on the within this atmosphere and on the earth surface also. हमको पता है कि air का weight होता है. You can take it और वो pressure भी डालता है. How do you come to know that it exerts force? When you see that whenever you try to fill the balloon with air too much beyond the capacity of the balloon, it blasts होता है ना. It proves that air has air exerts force on living and non-living things on the earth surface. And this air pressure is known, this is known as air pressure or atmospheric pressure. The force exerted by air on living and non-living thing is known as atmospheric pressure. And this is measured, the unit which is used to measure atmospheric pressure is known as millibars. And it is measured by an instrument known as barometer. Android barometer is the most convenient instrument which is used to measure it because it works without mercury. Okay. Was Devesh in the class earlier also? Was Devesh Motwani in the class? By his own name.
Ma'am.
Okay, in the figure just next to convenient because it works without mercury and also I have entered in. Okay, now it is saying that at normal atmospheric pressure at the sea level is 760 millimeter or 30 inches of the mercury, and then this 760 millimeter is expressed in millibars. That is its unit, millibar, its unit. Then it is 1013 millibars. That is 760 millimeter is equals to 1013 millibars. And if this mercury level rises beyond this point, agar hamara mercury level isse zyada badh jata hai, then we say air pressure is high. And when it falls below this minimum point, we say that the air pressure is low. Is it clear to everybody? Is it clear? Are you all having some network problem? Many of you are having some network problem.
Repeat kar do aap. Sab log ko samajh nahi aaya.
Ha?
Ma'am, Zoom update ho raha tha to hat gaya tha.
Okay. Yes, Nirbhay, you have any problem, Nirbhay?
Yes, ma'am, logo samajh mein nahi aaya.
Kaun sa? Which you are not able to understand?
Air pressure.
Atmospheric air pressure. We know that air exerts pressure. Air exerts force. Air force lagati hai sab pe. on the land surface and on the earth surface and also on the living and non-living thing. Air sab pe force lagata hai. And this force which is exerted by air is known as atmospheric pressure. Also, its unit of measuring, जैसे अपन रुपीस में मनी को काउंट करते हैं, ठीक है, distance is measured in meter and kilometer. Likewise, atmospheric pressure is measured in millibars. Its unit is millibars, and the instrument which is used to measure is barometer. And also Android barometer, which is given in the next image, you can see this Android barometer is the most convenient instrument because it works without mercury. क्योंकि इसको mercury की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती है. It works without it. हमको पता है ना. So now it is also said that normal atmospheric pressure, अगर हम देखें एक minimum pressure देखें, तो it is 760 millimeter or 30 inches of the mercury. But when this minimum temperature is measured in respect of millibars, then it is 1013 millibars. And if the atmospheric pressure goes beyond it, agar atmospheric pressure isse zyada ho jayega 1013 millibars se, it means air pressure zyada hai. Aur agar wo isse kam ho jata hai, it means air pressure is very low. इट इज जस्ट लाइक आप लोग टेम्परेचर मेजर करते हैं अपनी बॉडी का. डू वी ऑल मेजर द टेम्परेचर ऑफ अवर बॉडी? मिनिमम टेम्परेचर मैक्सिमम टेम्परेचर होता है ना अपनी बॉडी का. उससे ज्यादा हो जाता है तो हमें फीवर होता है, और उससे कम होता है, उससे कम होता ही नहीं है, बट मिनिमम टेम्परेचर तो हम क्या कहते हैं, अगर ज्यादा हो गया तो हमें फीवर हो गया, होता है ना ऐसे. इट इज जस्ट लाइक दैट ओनली.
Got it, Nirbhay?
Okay. Next, distribution of atmospheric pressure. Read next. Who will read? Manchika? Who wants to read? Anybody?
Ma'am, may I? Distribution of atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure is highest at the sea level, but on the mountains, the thickness and the density of air column is less, and hence the atmosphere pressure is also less. The atmosphere pressure on the surface of the earth is not the same. This is due to unequal heating of the atmosphere. In short, we can say that air pressure varies with temperature and altitude. Observe the following. Equatorial low pressure belt, subtropical high pressure belt in both hemispheres, subpolar low pressure belt in both hemispheres, polar high pressure belts.
Okay, now when we see that we have studied the two topics, the factors affecting the temperature, one was altitude, also was one of the important factor. Similarly, this atmospheric pressure is also not same at all the level of the earth surface. Yani pure earth surface pe bhi atmospheric pressure har jagah same nahi hota hai. It is highest at the sea level. Yani atmospheric pressure jo hota hai sea level, yani jo hota hai highest, yani nadi ke jo upar ka jo part hota hai, yani earth surface just upar agar hum aate hain, वहां पे मैक्सिमम होता है. बट माउंटेन एरियाज जहाँ पे थिकनेस एंड डेंसिटी बोथ ऑफ द एयर इज वेरी लेस, हमको पता है माउंटेन एरिया में एयर जो होता है कम होता है और उसकी थिकनेस भी कम होती है, डेंसिटी यानी क्वांटिटी भी कम होती है. सो बिकॉज डेंसिटी एंड डेंसिटी एंड थिकनेस ऑफ एयर इज वेरी लेस, जब एयर ही कम होगी तो एयर का प्रेशर भी कम होगा, ठीक है. बिकॉज माउंटेन एरिया में एयर की डेंसिटी एंड थिकनेस इज लेस, देयरफॉर द एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर विल आल्सो बी लेस. आल्सो दिस एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर इज नॉट सेम, इट इज नॉट सेम ऑन द एंटायर सरफेस ऑफ द अर्थ, पूरे अर्थ सरफेस पर भी सेम नहीं होता है. यस,
टाइम हो गया.
आई नो आदित्य खुराना इज लाफिंग एट यू. ओके.